I'd now like to introduce our first witness. He is the Honorable Lincoln Diaz-Balart, an attorney and consultant based in Miami, Florida. He's a former member of Congress, where he served with great distinction between 1993 and 2011. He is here today to share, for the first time, a moving and personal story about Lincoln Gabriel. I greatly appreciate you being here, Lincoln. Normally at this time we would swear in a witness, but after consulting with the chairman and the ranking member, we all agree that an oath to be sworn is not necessary today because you speak from the heart. And the heart binds a voice to the truth far greater than a mere oath would. So with that, I will now give you time for your opening statement.
Mr. Chairman and Ranking Member DeGette, members of the committee, when you called, Mr. Chairman, last week and graciously asked if I would consider speaking here today, I consulted with my son Daniel. He and his older brother, our dearly beloved Lincoln Gabriel, LG, were very close. And I have ultimate trust in Daniel's judgment. I explained to Daniel what you had told me, Mr. Chairman, with the subcommittee and the experts, and the Surgeon General, who will testify here today, will consider helping loved ones in mental health crisis. Daniel's words were, "Of course LG would want you to be there. If one person who might not otherwise get help is able to get treatment because of that hearing and its aftermath, LG would be happy." My son Lincoln Gabriel was a blessing to all who got to know him. He was all love. His was not a theoretical love, it was a constant practical love, demonstrated by his daily actions. And above all, by his deep respect for all human beings. LG was ultimately generous, he was intelligent, courageous, and of profound religious faith. He never allowed his illness, his deep depression, for which he took medication, to stop him from demonstrating his respect and his love for all human beings he came across. Christina, Daniel, and I miss him dearly, and we will continue to miss him for the rest of our days in the hope of our ultimate reunion with him. I have never met anyone more respectful of all human beings than my son Lincoln Gabriel. As I said, he was all love. I must admit, I believed that all you need is love. I never thought our tragedy of May 19, 2013 was possible. But it was possible. Sometimes, love is not enough. Assertive, proactive intervention is sometimes required to get needed treatment to those in mental health crisis. And thorough discussion of their illness with those who are sick. I have come before you today to thank you for focusing on this painful issue and to thank the mental health experts, the physicians, those in the NGOs, in the executive branch, the Surgeon General, all those working to prevent tragedies such as the one my family experienced. Please find common ground. Overcome differences in order to make progress. As my son Daniel said, if one person who might not otherwise get help is able to get treatment because of this hearing and its aftermath, LG would be happy. Thank you.